pleasant good morning to you and welcome to another edition of Soul2Soul Ministry Moment. I'm so glad that you are here today to talk with me just a little bit about your faith level. How is your faith level? Today we're going to talk a little bit about a concept that's close to my heart, and it's called the press of perseverance. I love this because as we begin to look at life and we are trying to persevere through some things, we have to understand the concept of the press in perseverance. Paul writes to the church at Philippi a letter that I think is very important. In Philippians chapter 3, verse 13 and 14, he says, "Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth into those things which are before." And then he says, "I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus." It's interesting because before Paul goes into the press for the mark and the prize, he says, there's one thing I must do, forgetting those things which are behind. You see, in times like these, we begin to be very reminiscent of better times, especially when we're facing crisis. And sometimes we can get into the place where we give up on the future because we think that the best of our life is behind us. I'm here to tell you today that the best of your life is not behind you. The best of your life is ahead of you. But then there are times when we look backwards and we look at all of the things that we struggle with, some of the things that we think can hold us down, some of the things that sometimes disqualify us from moving forward, or at least we think they do. I want to tell you today that we've got to get rid of those things. We've got to forget those things that's behind us that sometimes minimize our ability to move forward. And so today I want to give you a power thought. Today is your day to let go of things that no longer serve you. I'm going to say it again. Today is your day to let go of things that no longer serve you. You see, too many people, often quite gifted people, accomplish much less than they otherwise could have accomplished simply because they give up. They buckle under the pressure of the press. You see, the press of persistence requires us to take a stand and to go on resolutely in spite of frustrations, in spite of opposition, or any proposed alternatives to abort the plan and the process of God. Paul writes to Timothy a letter, and he calls us to persistence, or perseverance, if you will, but he adds another dimension that protects you and I from falling into a deep chasm of discouragement when our own best human efforts fall short. Here's what he says. "You then, my child, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus." In essence, when hindrances and troubles come, be strong in understanding and embracing the favor that is in Christ Jesus. Stay focused on favor, not on that which seems unfortunate. I'm going to say it again. I don't care how bad the obstacle is that's before you. I don't care what you're struggling with that's behind you. Be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus speaks this. When hindrances come in your life, when troubles come in your life, be strong in understanding and embracing the favor that is in Christ Jesus. Stay focused on favor, not on that which seems unfortunate. There was a book I read recently called The Last Lecture by Randy Parsh, and he talks about brick walls, opposition, things that hinder us. He says this about the brick walls. He says, "The brick walls are there for a reason. The brick walls are there not to keep us out. The brick walls are there to give us a chance to show how badly we want something. Because the brick walls are there to stop the people who don't want it badly enough. They're there to stop the other people." The brick walls are there, and I love what he says, it's not to stop us. It's to see how badly we want what God wants to give us. The challenges that we're facing in life, it's not to discourage us. It is to challenge us to want what God wants for us as much as God wants it for us. We struggle with the brick wall simply because we try to do many things in our own human efforts. Our human efforts must depend upon God's efforts inside our life as well. Yes, we must put forth the effort, but sometimes those efforts are based on the limited capacity we place on ourselves. You can do much more than you think you can do. That is why it's so important to depend upon an Almighty God. Winston Churchill says this. He says, "It's not enough that we do our best. Sometimes we must do what is required." That was very powerful to me because our best is not always compared to what God requires from us, because many times we think that what God requires of us is just too hard. Listen, God knows that we need help in everything that we are faced with and challenges. That's the reason why He has given us His Word. And not only that, He has given us His Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God that lives inside of us, that empowers us to do what we couldn't normally do in our own strength and in our own efforts. Now, the press is forward movement with opposition. So opposition is not going to go away. The press involves your persevering participation in the kingdom process of struggle. Notice how participation and perseverance go hand in hand. Participation is the act of effort against opposition, whereas perseverance is the continuing act of effort in opposition. So it's not enough to just say that you've attempted something. You've got to keep on pressing. You got to keep on pushing. You got to keep moving forward regardless of what you're facing in life. Romans chapter 1, verse 19 through 20 speaks to us that we can learn something from God's other creations, the animals, the trees, the vegetation, many things. Jesus even used parables using seeds, saying that a seed must first go into the ground and die in order for it to become fruitful. Look at what Romans says, chapter 1, verse 19 through 20. It says, "That which may be known of God is manifest in them, for God has showed it unto them. For the invisible things of Him from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things which are made, even His eternal power and Godhead, so that they are without excuse." And so today I want to use something that God has created in order to help us understand the importance of the process of pressing in perseverance. It's called the chick and the egg process. This process sheds light on the biblical principle of the press. Although the hatching normally takes 21 days, most of the eggs are pecked on for the 20th day or on the 20th day. Actually, pecked on is the wrong expression, because there is not enough room inside of the egg for the chick to lift his head to peck. Until a short time before hatching out, the chick's head lies on its breast. Then it lifts its head, pressing a hole into the eggshell by means of a thorn that's located right on the beak. I want you to remember that, the thorn on the beak. And so by moving inside all the time that he's in there, the whole eggshell begins to crack. And then the chick presses against the eggshell. As it lifts the back of the neck, it finally opens the lid. Hear me well. You may feel like you're trapped inside of this thing that's inside of your life, but I'm here to tell you, you can break free. You have to understand the process of the chicken and the egg. He's inside of that egg, just like you're inside your cocoon of troubles. You got to keep on moving, and you got to keep on pressing. This is what God requires from all of us. Through faith and patience, persistence in the press will have you delivered out of and standing on the other side of your situation. Now, remember what I said about the thorn? The chick has his head on his breast and the thorn is on its beak. And when it is time, he begins to push through what has already been cracked. So I want to give you a concluding power thought. Your thorn is necessary for your breakthrough. I'm going to say it again, and I want you to let it sink into your spirit. Your thorn is necessary for your breakthrough. Notice now that the mother hen does not help the chick at all to get out of the eggshell. The chick presses at the thing that secures it and brings it comfort in order for it to be free, to be exposed to its greater possibilities. Likewise, there are some things that we have to understand about the world in and of itself. The world may bring us security. The world may bring us some level of comfort. But here's what Paul writes to the church at Rome. He says, "Be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind." The world may bring you security, but understand this, that security comes with limits. The world may bring you some level of protection, but within that protection, it also prevents you from the things of God. The world may bring you some level of comfort, but let me tell you this, in order for you to get the comforts of the world, you must conform to the world. So here are three things I need you to understand. What secures you also limits you, and what protects you also prevents you, and what comforts you also conforms you. Where God is taking you, my dear friend, requires a certain strength that can only be obtained by a certain kind of struggle. Just like the chick and the egg, if you want the freedoms and the possibility beyond the things that is conforming and constricting and you think securing you, you've got to keep on pressing. You've got to keep on moving. And today, that is my ministry moment word to you. And I pray that in the times that you're living in right now, that you consider these things. Think on these things, the Bible says. Meditate on them. And watch God do a tremendous work inside of your life. Keep on pressing. Let me pray for you. Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you today for the opportunity to meet with my dear friends and partners once again in a time of ministry moment, soul to soul. I pray, dear Father, that you touch them afresh today. And I pray that the word of pressing persistence be something that resonate inside of their spirit as they are facing their day and their week. I pray again for healing. I pray for deliverance. I pray, dear Father, for their health, their mental health, their physical health. Father, I pray for relationships and their families. I pray, Father, that your favor rest upon them, that your blessed anointing, that it not only fills them, but it engulfs them and wrap them up, O Father, in your loving arms. I pray today for their fearless forward movement. In Jesus' name, we declare it done. Amen, amen, and amen. Thank God for joining me this morning. Thank you today for what God is going to do through you. In Jesus' name, have an amazing day.